Good morning, students of class 8. Today we will be starting with the chapter non-finite verbs, which is the 10th chapter in your English language. Verbs can be finite or non-finite. So there are two types of verbs, finite or non-finite. A verb that has a subject and shows tense, person and number is called a finite verb. So, a verb that has a subject, shows tense, person and number is called a finite verb, where you know where is the subject and in what tense is the sentence stated in what person is the statement speaking, and in what number. So, basically, a finite verb is a verb that shows the subject, verb and the object of the sentence. For example, I live in India, my sister lives in America. So these kind of verbs, these kind of sentences where every information about the sentence is complete, so those verbs are known as finite verbs. For example, if I say the sentence, the man has been eating ice cream. So here, the man is the subject. It also shows the number as in singular. So man has been eating. So this is showing the tense. That is, this is present perfect continuous tense. Has been eating. And then there's an object. The object is ice cream. So the sentence is, the man has been eating ice cream. So this is a complete sentence, and therefore this is a finite verb. So the verb here, has been eating, are the finite verbs. He is playing marbles. So here the subject he and the tense, which is present continuous, he is playing, and the object marbles. So every information about the subject, about the sentence is complete. So one thing remember it very clearly, that the main verb of a sentence is always a finite verb. Non-finite verbs are the helping verbs. So basically, they give you an additional information. Non-finite verbs are the verbs that does not show tense. So here, a verb that has no subject and does not show person or number is called a non-finite verb. For example, I love to go to the fun park. Here, I love to go. So this does not mean that I have gone or I will be going or I am going. So this does not show any tense. This just simply states that I love to go to the fun park. So this has no subject, does not show person or number. So even if this has a subject, I love, does not show the person or the number. I love to go to the fun park. There's no tense in it. To classify the non-finite verbs further, we have three kinds. Infinitive, participles and gerunds. So, non-finite verbs are verbs that does not show the tense. Therefore, it's very difficult to state as to in which tense the statement is speaking. As I said earlier, it's never the main verb of a sentence. The main verb is always the finite verb. So, we'll begin with the first non-finite verb, which is the gerund. So here, the first type of non-finite verb that we are studying is gerund. So a gerund is a verb that ends in ing and is used as a verbal noun. So basically, any verb that ends in ing and works as a noun in a sentence are known as gerund. So they always end in an ing. Always remember this. The ending will always be in ing. Gerunds have the functions of both nouns and verbs. It may be the subject, the complement, or the object of a sentence, or the object of a preposition. So basically, uses of gerund, I'll elaborate a little later. So first, some examples of gerund. Like wrestling is a popular game. So wrestling here, the verb wrestle means it's a sport, right? So wrestle is something, wrestle is a verb. So, but when you use wrestling in a sentence like this, like wrestling is a popular game, here this means that it is the subject of the sentence, yes, but it is also used as a noun. I enjoy eating pastries. So eating as an individual verb is as an individual word is a verb, eating. What are you doing? I am eating. So individually eating is a verb, but when in such sentences, I enjoy eating pastries, it is the object of the sentence and it is here used as a noun. Like, she is fond of drinking milk. Again, drinking is a verb when taken individually, but here as the object of the preposition, fond of. So when, yes, the uses will come in later, sorry. So she is fond of drinking milk. So drinking individually taken is a verb, but when taken in sentences like this, she is fond of drinking milk. Here, drinking is used as a noun. What do you like? I like drinking milk. So in the above mentioned sentences, the ing words function like nouns. However, all these words are derived from verbs. Simple. When the ing form of the verb is used as a noun in a sentence, we call it a gerund. Coming up to the uses of gerund. So first, gerund is used as a subject of the verb. For example, cutting of trees is banned. So even if cut is the base form of the verb and cutting is a verb, cutting of trees is banned. So here, cutting of trees is used as a noun. So it is a subject of the verb. So here the verb is banned and this is the subject. This full statement is the subject. This full phrase, cutting of trees. As the object of a transitive verb. Now, what are transitive verbs? Transitive verbs are the verbs which only make sense if it exerts its actions on its objects. In simpler words, they can take an object. For example, those boys enjoy doing racing. So here, the word doing, so doing is not the gerund here, the gerund is racing. Doing is the transitive verb because it exerts its action on the object. So the object is racing. So doing is the transitive verb and here racing is the gerund, which is used as a noun. So transitive verbs are the verbs, again, those are the verbs which they can take an object. Like, they exert its actions on the object. For example, here, racing is the object and doing is a transitive verb which is exerting its actions on the object or the gerund. Now, another example of transitive verbs can be, for example, please bring coffee. So here, coffee is the object and bring is the transitive verb which exerts its actions on the object. So yes, so do this correction in your book. Now the third one is as the object of preposition. She was asked a reason for coming late. So here for is the preposition and coming is the gerund used. So whenever after a preposition you see a gerund, it is because it's used as the object of a preposition. Next, as the complement of a verb. My favorite pastime is playing video games. So here again, playing is the verb which is used as a noun here. So basically, playing with an ing used as a noun because playing video games is the phrase used in the object. So complement of the verb means so like in this example, my favorite pastime is playing video games. Now here the phrase playing video games is not used as a verb, but it is complementing the verb is. So if the sentence was like Amartya is playing video games, then in that one, in the sentence Amartya is playing video games, is playing video games is used as a verb and not as a noun. But here, my favorite pastime is playing video games. Here, this phrase is used as a noun and it is the complementing the verb, the base verb is. This is the helping word, right? In a verb. So it is complementing this helping verb is. Gerund can also be used as an absolute phrase independent of the main clause. It does not need to always have a main clause attached to it. For example, playing football is his passion. He devotes a lot of time on it. Playing football, here playing is used as a noun. Playing football is his passion. He devotes a lot of time on it. So this is independent of the main clause here. Like this is a complete sentence. Still not telling the tense of the sentence, but it is a complete sentence. Now what you have to do is exercise E, all of you have to do by your own self. We'll discuss this in the live class. Now a gerund phrase. A gerund phrase is a phrase that usually begins with a gerund and may be followed by an adverbial. What is an adverbial? An adverbial is relating to an adverb. It defines the sentence or the verb. Okay, so adverbial is something which is related to an adverb. What is an adverb? Which helps describe the verb. So it defines the sentence. Adverbial. Now for example of gerund phrase, making a mark in acting was her aim. So here, as you can see, making is a gerund, a mark is a noun phrase, and in acting is the adverbial. This one. Next sentence, I hope they understand the reason for my being unhappy. In this sentence, my is a possessive pronoun before gerund. Yes, and being is gerund. Unhappy is the adjective acting as a complement. A gerund phrase may be the subject of a sentence, the object of the main verb in the sentence, a subject complement or the object of a preposition. For example, so these are some of the uses of a gerund phrase, like in what manner can we use them. It can be the subject of a sentence, the object of the main verb in a sentence, and the subject complement or the object of a preposition. So obviously the uses are the same as that of gerunds. So basically gerund phrase is any group of words that follows a gerund and which helps making the gerund complete in simpler tenses. So you can read out these statements. Finding my paper took the whole day. So basically finding is a gerund and finding my paper is the whole gerund phrase. I do appreciate your participating in my function. So participating is a gerund. Participating in my function. So this is the object of the verb appreciate. Lalit was awarded for being honest. Object for the preposition for being honest. The activity Nandan loves the most is playing in the park. Subject complement. Subject complement as in the subject here is Nandan and like the activity that Nandan loves, and this is complementing the subject, so it is telling you something about the activity. So the activity he loves the most is playing in the park. So now even this exercise F needs to be done in the book. I'll send you the pages. In the next class we'll be starting with infinitives and participles. So we'll be finishing this chapter in the next video. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next class.